My name is Dietmar Hutmacher. I'm a biomedical engineer, and some also call me Professor Gig. So in biomedical engineering, we bring together the biology to study the body, and then translate this to medicine. And we also use engineering, like physics, chemistry, then to bring that all together into one area for the benefit of the patient. We use 3D printing in different ways than people would use it at home. So we develop very special materials which allow that our cells would be able to survive and grow in what we call bio-inks. And we put the cells into these bio-inks, and then we print them out with very special printers. So we have infinite number of cells in our body. Every organ in our body has many, many different cell types. So we have more than 40 to 50 billion cells in our body. We take, for example, your cells from any part of your body, and then we can take those cells and we can multiply them. So we can take 1,000 cells from you, and we can multiply the 1,000 cells within 2 or 3 weeks to 100 million cells. And then we can use these cells, put them into our bio-inks, and then print them out. And then when we put them in the body, then they will help the body to regenerate. So some of my work is also related to broken bones. So if bone breaks and it doesn't heal, then we also have a larger hole actually in the bone. And that is then very, very difficult to heal. And again, we use our technology where we would 3D print a scaffold, that we would computer animation work to simulate the piece which is missing. And we would print the exact replica of the piece which would be missing in form of a scaffold, which are basically templates which are implanted into the defect, and then transplant the scaffold together with tissue into the defect. And after 2 to 3 years, the patient would be left only with his own bone, because the polymer we are using to 3D print the scaffold is biodegradable. The scaffold is like a very porous framework which helps to fuse the bone together. Engineers are involved in anything which surrounds us. If you think about in the houses we live, the technology which is in there is designed and built by engineers. When we look at our cars, engineering is involved in everything. And I think this is very rewarding when you see that you have designed something and it is used by other people. And what is really important is that you have the basics. So to do that, you really need to study either biology, chemistry, mathematics, and physics, so that you really have the education to be a good engineer. And even so, sometimes it's tough, but when you can apply this in engineering, I can guarantee you, you will be a very, very happy woman or man. The hardest part of the job is that I have many different interdisciplinary team members. So they all come with a different education, and they all speak a different professional language. However, to treat at the end the patient, we all need to speak the same language towards to develop something which will help the patient. And that is sometimes very, very challenging, because sometimes it's like a computer crash when those people at the beginning talk to each other. Part of my job is that every morning when I wake up, I'm so excited to go into the lab, because there are so many things we do which interest me and which give me every day a lot of job satisfaction. It is so exciting all the time.